Hello, and welcome to this wonderful episode of GCK Daily. Here, we appreciate Christ's character and nature. Both have been deeply felt and seen at past global crusades. Join us today as we understand more of who Christ is. The key to dominion is a sincere heart. But what dominion is in question here? This dominion is the one that grants complete victory over the roots of our afflictions, sins, and depravity. A sincere heart of repentance grants us complete victory over the roots of self and sin. The Bible is a love letter that testifies of God's faithful nature and character. But I'm not here to tell you to just read the words. I'm here to ask you to see Him in His Word and surrender your heart to Him. So let's listen as Dr. Kumi lays bare for us the paths to dominion and victory.
Isaiah chapter 26, verse 13. O Lord, our God, other lords beside thee have had dominion over us. Look at that language. Hear that declaration. O Lord, our Creator, O Lord, our God, O Lord, our Redeemer, other lords beside thee have had dominion over us. Think about your life. Do like Job said, I will not hide my sin under a cover. O Lord, our God, other lords have had dominion over us. Alcohol has had dominion over some people. Immorality has had dominion over some people. And corruption, stealing, whether they're stealing government money or stealing their neighbor's money, stealing has had dominion over some people. And for some people, covetousness has had dominion over them. O Lord, our God, all the lords beside thee, little L, lost, has had dominion over them. Little L, lying, has had dominion over them. Little L, lasciviousness, has had dominion over them. O Lord, our God, if we're sincere like that, and we come to the Lord with open heart and with sincerity, and we say, this we know, all the lords have had dominion over us, but we want to turn around, but want to have total repentance, but we're looking for restoration, but by thee only we will make mention of thy name. Those are the people that are asking for a change of life, a change of heart, and they want to have the original dominion that God created Adam and Eve with. Tonight, you can have that original dominion. How does that happen? Acts chapter 3. I'm reading from verse 19. Acts chapter 3. Repent ye therefore. You want dominion? Repent ye therefore. You want a new life? Repent ye therefore. And you want authority over every evil sin in life? Repent ye therefore and be converted. Let me remind you three things again. Number one, created for dominion. Number two, corrupted, losing dominion. Number three, converted, now to have and to regain dominion. Tonight, there'll be dominion over sin. Tonight, there'll be dominion over sickness. Tonight, there'll be dominion over every satanic attack and satanic affliction in Jesus' name. Complete. Complete. Complete.
Our hearts is the hardest thing to surrender because a surrendered heart is equal to our complete loss of control. And dominion is not about reclaiming control of your life and world. It's all about a surrendered heart. I say again that the key to dominion is a sincere heart. Let's continue to listen to God's word and take the next steps towards complete dominion.
Hello, friends. This is Paul Balash, and you're watching GCK Daily with Dr. Kumuyi.
The people will come and they say, Lord, I'm coming. Lord, I'm coming. And as you have said, repent ye therefore. You want authority, power, dominion, and you want total freedom. Therefore, if that's what you want, repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. It will take the cleaner, the melting, the eraser from heaven. It will wipe away all your sin, that they will not be remembered against you anymore. That's what he's expecting to do. That's what he loves to do. And that's what he plans to do for everyone that will look at their lives as the Lord is asking them, where art thou? Today is not Adam, it's you. It says, repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. He will do it. I said, he will do it. Now, that is the number one glorious, wonderful thing the Lord wants to do. He wants you to have his nature of righteousness again, his nature of righteousness and purity again, because he doesn't want sins in our lives. He wants his nature to be in us. He wants his image to be in us, that it will come and then he'll blot out your sins when the time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. In verse 26, it says, unto you first, God, having raised up his son, Jesus, sent him to bless you in turning away. Look at that. In turning away, every one of you from his iniquities. Tonight is your night. As you trust in the Lord, as you believe in the Lord, salvation will come. As you believe in the Lord, dominion will come in your life again in Jesus' name. And every evil thing that has dominated your life, oppressed your life, and almost driven you into doing evil, the Lord will break the power of sin out of your life tonight in Jesus' name.
Dominion, this is God's will for you. It begins with having a relationship with Jesus Christ, the one who died to set you free. Christ longs to save you and to heal you. Pastor Kumi comes to us now with that exact offer, and I urge you to accept the Lord today.
Father, in the name of Jesus, our Savior and Lord, who died for us on the cross of Calvary, we come believing the promise you have given, that whosoever comes to you in repentance, you will in no wise cast away. We ask, O Lord, all these who have come, forgive their sins in Jesus' name. Take away the guilt. Take away the condemnation. And give them the power of a new life in Jesus' name. Take the condemnation away. And give them peace of heart and victory over all the evil of the past in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We know you have answered. Let them have the assurance of your salvation now. In Jesus' name we pray.
My name is Blessing Francis. I'm from Gaso local government area of Taraba State. I am here to testify to the goodness of God, what He has done in my life. I was having excruciating pain in my stomach, not knowing what the problem was. When I went to the hospital, the doctor diagnosed fibroid and I was booked for operation. But it all happened on the day that our Pastor W.F. Kumwi will come to Jalingo for supernatural liberation through Christ Global Crusade. On the day he landed Jalingo, the joy of his arrival overwhelmed my heart and I felt pressed. I went to the restroom. And there, the supernatural power of God touched me, and the fibroid came out on its own. What I would have spent money in the hospital, the Lord did it for me, free of charge. And I am singing for joy that what God has done for me, not even the world, nor the devil can take it away from me. Praise the Lord.
Raise up that hand and lay the other hand where you have the problem. And that thing, sickness, pain, whatever, everything will vanish out of your body. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, because of what you are able to do. And what you plan to do, and what you have promised you are going to do. We ask, O Lord, that you touch every life right now in Jesus' name. Manifest your power. Manifest your authority. Manifest your dominion over sickness, over Satan, over every evil thing in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord, where there is sickness, there will be health. Where there's any damage, you bring repair to every part of their lives, every part of their body, right now in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray you knock up the hand of Satan out of everyone's body, everyone's life, everyone's family right now in Jesus' name. Over here, over the radio, over the television, anywhere and everywhere, online, in every location right now, manifest your power and destroy the works of the devil. Lord, I pray those blind eyes, open them now in Jesus' name. Deaf and dumb, make them to hear, make them to speak in Jesus' name. And those who are paralyzed or having arthritis or any kind of a problem, impediment in their motion, in their walking, let your power come to them now. Heal them in Jesus' name. I pray for every swelling, whether it's cancer or whatever, remove it right now. Heal them in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that every kind of a problem or pain or sickness, whatever the name may be, they will bow under the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Dominion everywhere. Healing everywhere. Deliverance everywhere. Miracle everywhere for everyone. I pray, Lord, to the left, to the right, to the center, to the back, and everywhere, confirm miraculous healing right now. Thank you, Lord, because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The Lord has answered in Jesus' name. Check up yourself and you'll find your miracle of healing, deliverance, dominion is already there.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Sing it with me. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. O my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawn. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the now, come on.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul. I worship Your holy name.
Thank you for joining us for another episode of GCK Daily, Global Crusade with Kumuyi. We are sure that this episode has been a great reminder of God's readiness to intervene in the matters of your soul and life.
So please check us out at gckhq.org and connect with us via our social media handles. Please also like and subscribe and share these videos. We look forward to seeing you at the next episode of GCK Daily. We would love for you to join us at their next Global Crusade.